ladies and gentlemen, and once again, welcome to the Grand. For better viewing, please extinguish your table candles at this time. Management requests that you refrain from smoking. An actor's equity prohibits the use of cameras and recording devices. Also, please use care, for the theater aisles will be used by the actors for their entrances and exits. At the scene of this performance, the role of Julian Marsh, usually played by Mark Vance, will be played by Michael Norris. And now, the Grand Dinner Theater proudly presents 42nd Street.
Still an audition, damn it! Julian doesn't want this job. The nearest bread line is around the corner. Okay, next.
Looking for someone?
The dance director? I'm here to get into the show!
Oh, you're a little bit late. We already picked the chorus. You should have been here in 10.
Oh, I was! But it took me an hour to get up enough courage to go through the stage door. You're not Mr. Marsh, are you?
No, Billy Lawler. One of Broadway's better juveniles. You say, I'll bet you're new to show business.
Well, I've had experience.
Oh, really? How many shows?
Any number of them.
Well, such as?
Would have been my first, if they had taken me.
I'd take you any day. How about having lunch?
No, I've got to see the dance director.
Well, the dinner then, or lunch tomorrow.
Gee, you're really very kind, but I really got to see the dance.
I know a bundle of humanity. She's about so high. I'm nearly driven to insanity. When she passes by, she's a sunny little honey. But oh, so hard to kiss. I'll try to overcome her vanity, and then I'll tell her this. I'm young and healthy, and you've got charms. It would really be a sin not to have you in my arms. I'm young and healthy, and so are you.
Soft soap, Andy. I need this job as much as you do.
Wall Street got you too?
You know the old saying, there's a horse's ass for every light on Broadway. All right, so the crash got me down for the count. I am still Julian Marsh, dammit! And Pretty Lady's gonna put me back on top. Let's talk about the cast.
Oh, best in town. Billy Lawler for the juvenile.
Maggie and I for the character stuff.
And Dorothy Brock in the lead.
It's Brock I'm worried about. Her last hit was 10 years ago.
We have to use her, Julian. She's got Abner Dillon in her back pocket.
Yeah, you know, Dillon's kitty cars. He's agreed to put up the whole 100,000 if she's the star.
But she can't dance.
Put a lot of girls around her. Let her wave her arms a lot. The public will never know the difference.
Easy, boss. Here she comes.
Dorothy, may I?
Yes, I will. I want to do this myself. Mr. Marsh, ever since I was a tiny little girl and saw my first Julian Marsh show, I have dreamed of the day that I might work with the King of Broadway. Alas, that day has come, and I am filled with pride, joy, and humility.
Thanks, Miss Brock. I'm feeling rather full myself. Now, before we go any further, I'd like to try you out on one of the numbers.
Hold on, Mr. Marsh. Dorothy don't need to try out. She's already got a contract.
Mr. Dillon, what would I do without you? By the way, there were a few items you forgot to mention, so I just filled them in myself. Limousine.
Dorothy.
Decorated dressing room. Private maid. No problem about the salary. I just added another zero.
Now, see here, Dorothy, we can't afford it.
If there are any objections, I won't insist. We'll just peddle our kitty cars, and you can go peddle your fish.
You're not hearing me, Miss Brock. I'd like to try you out on one of the songs to see if you can handle the role.
If you are asking me to audition, Mr. Marsh, I'm afraid the answer is no.
Oh, it's an audition. He just wants to know if it's in the right key.
Oh, try that new one we went over yesterday, Dorothy. You're gonna love it. Now, Andy and I see you in this low-down dive. The piano pounds out this hot jazz beat as you enter and sing. Shadows on the wall. I see them all. Here and there.
Wardrobe!
Hello, kid!
Matt, what are you doing?
thought I'd drop by and see my best girl.
And what if Mr. Dillon had been here, Patrick Kemp? This is just too dangerous. Meet me in my dressing room at 5.
Dorothy, I hate meeting in corners like this.
Isn't it better than not meeting at all?
Don't worry, the bankroll's intact.
Thank you, Miss...
Oh, Jones.
Maggie Jones. Say, kid, you look like you could use some grub. How about putting on the feed bag with me and the girl?
Oh, no, thank you,
Miss Jones.
Oh,
not another word, it's all set.
Hey, kid, I've been looking for you. How about having lunch?
I'm sorry, I'm going with Miss Jones and the girls.
Well, would you like to join us?
No thanks. I'm looking for a mouthful, not an earful. But don't worry, I'll give you a rain check.
Ow. What makes Tanner such wolves? I think it's that tight underwear they wear.
No, that's what makes them tenors. Come on, girls, I'm taking you to that lovely place with no window.
The after room!
The automat! All right, the gypsy tea kettle. But you're gonna dance your way over. I don't want to waste any time.
I don't know your steps.
Oh, well, if you think you can pick them up, I'll show them.
Okay.
Yeah.
think you're doing? Here I am knocking my brains out trying to put together a show they'll pay good money to see. You're giving it away free in the street!
Oh, you think it's
now you guys get back in there. Oh, this is great. Just great.
Something wrong, Wolf.
Wrong? I'm shy of one girl, that's what's wrong.
But you told me to pick 2 dozen girls with great legs.
Plus, one for good measure, Andy. I always pick one for good measure.
I don't remember you
asking. Adam, don't give me any excuses. Just get me another girl.
Oh, well, I could have one here, say, first thing in the morning.
Oh, that's just Duffy. I could hardly wait. I'm supposed to set the boardwalk number this afternoon. I've got a good mind to walk up to the first girl I see in the street. Just go up to the first dame who passes by and say, you.
Oh, me?
Yeah, you. Can you dance?
I am from Allentown, Pennsylvania! And I can do any dance step ever invented! Wings! Sprinkles! Hubbles! Shuffles!
Take it easy, you got the job. Andy, get her ready to rehearse at 2 o'clock sharp.
2 o'clock sharp!
Hey, wait a minute! I hear the Mack truck tried to run me down this morning.
I'm sorry. I didn't know that it was you! It'll never happen again, I swear on my mother! I swear on my father!
Hey, relax, kid, relax! I kind of enjoyed it. Now get in there and learn those routines. We got a show to do!
Thank you, Mr. Marsh! Thank you!
Brock and Billy, I want to run the boardwalk number with the dialogue.
We can't do the dance section. Gladys is out cold.
Then use Winnie.
Oh, no, boss. Winnie's in the number before. She'll never make that change.
Oh, well, get that new kid from Allentown. Show her what to do. We'll put a costume on her later. I gotta run this number right now. Miss Brock, Billy, let's go! It is morning. The sun sparkles brightly on the section of the boardwalk at Atlantic City. As we discover Rodney and Madeline, Madeline speaks.
Darling, darling, why did you take so long to declare yourself? The answer, of course, is yes. We'll live together in a cottage by the sea, and every morning we'll have breakfast and kisses in bed. Oh, my God.
And Rodney said,
and will you always love me, Madeline?
Yes, 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 yes. Yes.
Oh. Rodney declares his love, and they kiss.
Hold on a minute!
What's that fella doing to Dorothy?
I'm just acting, Mr. Dillon.
I don't care what you call it. I ain't putting up good money to see the lady I love kissed by no actor.
All right, cut the kiss. Just say the speech and improvise something.
Oh, my darling, I love you, I worship you, I adore you.
I don't know exactly how it started, but it started in fun. I just wanted someone to be gay with, to play with someone. But now I realize that I could never let you go, and I've come to tell you so. Yes, every hug seems to act just like a drug. I need you for my own.
name is Peggy Sawyer. She's new. Are you okay, kid? She fainted!
Thank God!
Wait, it's not Peggy's fault. She didn't eat any lunch.
Billy, take her in the Bronx dressing room. The rest of you, this is still a rehearsal. Andy, I want you to clean up that last section before the pivot.
Downstairs, the last section before the pivot.
Okay, easy. Set it down.
What happened?
Hey, one of the kids fainted. And she comes to. Tell her that I will be back as soon as I get a break. Her name is Lawler. Billy Lawler.
Come on, Billy.
You all right?
I guess I fainted.
Good guess.
But I guess I'm all right now.
Oh, bad guess. Now let me be the doctor for a while. What you need is some rest.
The rehearsal isn't over yet.
Oh, yes, it is, young lady. For you, anyway. Now, as your doctor, my first prescription is for you to sit down. That's it. And as your doctor, my second prescription is for you to get those legs up.
And I'll bet I know what your third prescription is.
Dorothy, I didn't expect you to.
Well, obviously you didn't expect me, doctor. Oh,
darling, she fainted. They brought her in until she came to.
And since when is my dressing room an emergency ward for every clumsy Corrine who throws a little fainting act? I'll get her out of here before I prescribe some medication she won't like so much.
Please, Miss...
You shut up! And if you don't like my prescription, doctor, then you can just get out with her.
What in the hell do you think you're...
What the hell is going on in here?
I am trying to conduct a rehearsal on that stage. Who are you?
My name is Pat Denny, Mr. Marsh. I was a guest of Miss Brock's.
That will beat it. Miss Brock's official gentleman friend happens to be in the house. I wouldn't want him to get any funny ideas.
Julian, this is really a...
Andy, please take Miss Brock on stage.
Dorothy,
Mr. Denny, your presence in this dressing room has caused a great deal of unnecessary turmoil, and I strongly suggest that such visits do not occur again. Oh, and Mr. Denny, this kid's a pretty good hooker. I'd hate to lose her over the price of a bowl of chili. Take her out and get her something to eat. Miss Brock, may I have a word with you?
Of course, Julian. Is this about the character that I'm playing?
It's about the character you're playing around with. I don't know what the hell went on in that dressing room, but pretty lady means far too much to me to let some gigolo stand in its way. I want you to give him up.
Aren't you a bit confused, Julian? You are the director of my show, not my personal life.
Well, your personal life gets in the way of my show. I direct that, too.
Mr. Marsh, I shall see whom I please, when I please. And no show is going to stand in my way.
Andy, I think we've got ourselves a little problem.
Yeah.
But I think I got myself a little solution. Nick Murphy.
Murphy? He's a killer. Boss, you don't like the song, just say so.
I put a girlfriend of his in my last show. He owes me a favor. Maybe he can send over a couple of his boys to persuade Pat Denny to make himself scarce for a few weeks.
Julian, I just got a call from Atlantic City. They canceled our booking. But everything's okay. We picked up a week at the Arch Street Theater in Philadelphia.
But all our shows open in Atlantic City. Maybe Philly will change your luck. Maybe he's right.
Come on, let's get packing. I'm grabbing my hat and coat.
I'm leaving the cat a note. Quick, call me a ferry boat, get out of town.
Sorry I couldn't take any place fancier, but the old purse strings are a bit frayed at the moment.
Hey, you in the company?
Yes, I am.
Give this to Dorothy Brock. Tell her that Pat Denning has joined a stock company in Philadelphia with no forwarding address.
Sure thing.
I'm going in my trap. Big scoop in the daily news. Who'll save his tools getting out of town?
I do not want to go to Philadelphia. My contract says I must be out of town in Atlantic City.
But Dorothy, why don't you want to play in Philadelphia?
Who says I don't want to play in Philadelphia? My contract says I must play out of town in Philadelphia.
Rehearsal in Philly starts at 8 o'clock sharp, so let's get moving!
My neighbors are awful nice. They promise to be the mice. Hey, I stand, no need to run. Getting out of town. Come back here and give the performance of your lives.
Company dismissed.
Company dismissed. Half hour's at 8 o'clock.
That's 8 o'clock, half
Peggy!
Hour.
Peggy!
Oh, Willard, I'm going to check those spot tubes.
I'm going to change and I'll meet you at the stage door.
I'll be there in a minute, Billy. Are you coming to the party, Mr. Marsh?
Huh?
To the Regency Club? Miss Jones just invited everyone. Something funny?
There you are. Eyes shining like a kid at Christmas. Dreams of parties, opening nights. The tinsel and glitter of musical comedy. But look at you. Just a speck of dust on the stage. Indistinguishable from the 40 other specks of dust I put there.
I know that, Mr. Marsh. But you put all those specks together into something alive and beautiful that can reach out to 1,000 people we've never seen before.
Broadway dreams, Sawyer. We've all had them.
Well, I mean to hold on to mine, Mr. Marsh.
So did I. Sweet dreams, kid.
They are. I'm a speck of dust in your show.
Andy? Andy, where the hell are you?
Right here, coming!
Got all the notes typed out, all 7 pages.
Ah, forget about the notes for now. I've decided to take some of my own advice and forget about everything till tomorrow. There's a party over at the Regency. Come on, let's go dream a little.
From this show.
Say, another one of those and they'll have to build a bridge over you.
They'll build a monument over you.
Get him! I turned around and you disappeared!
How does that feel, sweetie pie?
Laugh a day away at Cobra.
Say, what's eating you tonight?
I finally figured out what this show needs. A few more songs! Preferably by Irving Berlin.
Dorothy, you better
get away from me. And take old Buffalo Bill with you.
Hold on a minute.
Now, I got $100,000 in this show, so you better not give me the hair.
So then I'll give you the oil. Well, how about just a few bubbles?
No.
Why don't you get on your kitty car and pedal on back to Tulsa? You old beanpole.
She didn't mean that.
I did too.
She's all excited about the opening, you know, tomorrow.
There ain't gonna be no opening tomorrow. Not with Dorothy Rock. She's out of the show.
Wrong. Rock opens tomorrow as scheduled.
Oh, but here, Rock,
don't be a fool, Dylan. Are you gonna toss away all that money because of a dame?
It's my funeral, ain't it?
And the funeral of all these kids who've been dancing their feet off to give you a show you can be proud of. You're gonna put them out in the street, too?
Oh, you wouldn't do that, would you, Mr. Dillon?
Not after we put all our faith in you.
But you called me a beanpole and a cobra.
Well, listen, in show business, that's a compliment.
You know what you need? You need to have some fun. Why don't you come to a quiet corner and I'll send you the scores of my last 7 shows. Come on, Mr. Dillon.
Pat, thank God you got my message.
Just calm down and tell me what's wrong.
Oh, well, in a minute. Just hold me first.
What are you gonna do about Denny, boss?
Call Nick Murphy. I think he's got a couple of Philadelphia cousins who can come over and handle the situation. Let's go find a phone.
Just hold me and never let me go.
Miss Rock.
Well, well, well. But isn't the fainting violet Mr. Denning took to dinner last week?
I need to talk to Pat. There's going to be trouble.
You're damn right there is, unless you get the hell out
now
of here.
Wait a minute, Dorothy.
Don't you tell me to wait a minute. Then why are you taking her side of this thing anyway?
You don't understand.
I think I understand. All too well.
No, you don't.
Why don't the two of you just get the hell out of here?
Please, Miss
Brooke. It's all right, baby.
Now, Dorothy, you have got...
I said the two of you.
All right. If that's the way you want it...
That is the way I want it. Just get out of here. Get out! Next time, you think you can pull something like this on me? Pat? Pat? He's the only one. I know now I'm the lonely one. I had to learn how a heart can yearn. Emptiness can burn with no one to turn to. I know now that I can't forget. I can't. Oh, I don't know. I guess I never knew how I need.
Yeah! rings your buzzing, and that's the ballgame.
Then we have nothing to worry about. The finale's the best number in the act.
Well, there won't be a finale if Prop doesn't get out here. Dorothy, where the hell are you?
There is no need to shout, Julian. I can hear you.
Right, all right. You're on in about 10 seconds.
I have never missed a cue in my life. When I do, you can take me to task and not before.
Miss Brock, I just wanted to explain about that.
I don't want an explanation from you.
Please, Miss
Brock. Get away from me. The farther, the better.
Blazes, everyone. Come on. Q68, go!
Gentlemen, your tickets will be refunded at the box office. House lights!
That's not carrying the show.
Brock is such an easy performer, she's fooled you. And that sort of style takes years and experience to develop.
Unless this kid's got it naturally, which she just might have.
Yeah. You don't have any pages she'd have to learn, not to mention songs and routines.
She's young. Kids can do anything.
Yeah. Put the dancing back in the show.
Look, boss, it's worth a try.
Isn't it?
All right, send her in.
She just fired her.
Oh, but it may not be too late to get her back. She's taking the 11:10 to Allentown. That gives you 20 minutes to get down to the Broad Street station.
What do we do, boss?
Get Sawyer off that train. I want her in New York and ready to rehearse at 8 o'clock tomorrow morning.
And we're going to stay here in Philadelphia?
And lose $10,000 a night? No. Our best hope is to ship the show to New York, beat the party in 36 hours, and open cold on Thursday. Let's get going. Oh, wait a minute. This is my job. I fired her. I'll get her back.
I can go, boss.
No, I said I'll go. Thanks, Annie. Might have done me quite a favor.
Any time, Mr. Marsh?
Any time.
All right, we give him 15 minutes to convince her. Then we bring in the big guy.
Miss Peggy Sawyer, and that's just what I'm going to do.
Miss Sawyer, I'm here to apologize to you, to ask you to come back.
I have a train to catch, Mr.
And
Marsh.
Take over Dorothy Brock's role in Pretty Lady. She's broken her ankle. She's out of the show. If you can do it, the part's yours.
I'm sorry, Mr. Marsh. Show business just isn't for me. I'm going back to Allentown.
What's that word you said? Allentown? Sawyer, I'm giving you the chance to star in the biggest musical Broadway has seen in 20 years, and you say, Allentown? Now you listen, Sawyer. Even if you don't give a damn about me, think of all the kids you'll be putting out of work if you don't do this. Think of the songs that will wither and die unless you sing them. Think of the scenery that'll never be seen, the costumes never worn. The orchestration's never heard. Think of Pretty Lady and the thrill and pleasure it can give to millions of people. Think of musical comedy and the most glorious words in the English language. Sawyer, think of Broadway, dammit! Come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway. Hip hooray and ballyhoo, the lullaby of Broadway, the rumble of the subway train, the rattle of the taxis, the daffodils who entertain at Hatchelow's and Maxie's, when a Broadway baby says goodnight, it's early in the morning.
Thank you.
come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway.
Thank you. hurry. I want to go over the love scene.
Mr. Marsh, please. I'm exhausted. Can't we rest for just a minute?
Sawyer, that curtain goes up in 2 hours. It's now or never. Take it from Jim's entrance. What are you waiting for from Jim's entrance?
Jim, they didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come.
Oh, that's impossible. Sawyer, you're greeting the man you love. You gotta make it mean something. Like this. Jim. They didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come. Now you do it.
Jim. They didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come.
That'll never do. Sawyer, haven't you ever been in love? Haven't you ever had a man take you in his arms and crush you to him and kiss you? Now say the line.
Julian, tell me you were here. Grand of you to come.
Again.
Jim. They didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come.
Once more.
Jim, darling.
You didn't tell me you were here. It was grand, grand, grand.
That's it! Amy, get him out here!
Everyone, hurry! Music! Kids!
Let's go!
I know!
Please, Mr. Marsh, I can't! I can't!
Oh, now
you've done it, Marsh. You pushed her too far.
I had to. That curtain goes up in 45 minutes. If she doesn't know this part deep down in her gut, she'll never get through it. And that goes for the rest of you. Andy, take him in the lounge. Go over that last 16 bars.
All right, everybody. Down the lounge.
Move it.
I want to say to Miss Sawyer. So, you're taking my place.
I'm sorry. I know how tough it must be.
Do you? I'm not so sure. When I started for the theater this morning, I wanted to tear your heart out. I wanted to hate you. I wanted to see you fail. You! Singing my songs, wearing my costumes, playing my role. Sitting in that theater, watching you rehearse, I found I couldn't hate you. Because you're good. Maybe even better than I would have been. The public wants youth, freshness, and beauty. And Peggy, that's what you've got. Only I'm getting something, too. For 10 years, the theater has kept me away from the one thing I've ever really wanted. It took a broken ankle to finally make me realize it. Pat Denning and I were married this morning.
Oh, Miss Brock!
I've only got one more wish for you, my dear. You get out there and be so swell. You'll make me hate you. Sawyer, there is one more thing. It's about the next to the last number. You have got to take it easy. Let the audience come to you. Would you let me show you what I mean?
I would appreciate it very much. Dorothy. Somebody's eyes look into your room. Life begins when you get that guy all alone.
but for us, the kids in the line. You're not just Peggy Sawyer tonight. You're every girl the way they kicked up her heels in the chorus. Now get out in front, kid, and show them what we can do.
Annie, let it slowly fill. I'll do my best, I promise.
Your best? That's not good enough. I want better than your best. I want sheer, unadulterated brilliance! Now you kids, what are you doing here? Getting your places for the opening. Sawyer, I want to talk to you.
Julian, it's 8:40. We gotta call places.
Yeah, they waited this long. They can wait another 5 minutes. Now listen, Sawyer. And listen hard. 100 people. 100 jobs. $100,000, 5 weeks of sweat and blood and grind, and it all depends on what you do out there tonight. Oh, I know what you're thinking. Here comes Marsh with another one of his pep talks. Well, this is the last of them, Sawyer, and it comes straight from the heart. Our hopes, our dreams, our lives are in your hands. Get out there and make them shine with your golden talent. This afternoon it was acting. But this one I mean.
Julian, we've got to begin.
Tell him to take the house to half. Sawyer, you're going out there a youngster. But you've got to come back a star!
Shuffle off the top of the wall. Someday the
I can't remember a single lyric.
You will do the rest of the show, and without any mistakes, and without this thing either. I am Julian Marsh, damn it, and I say you will.
Oh!
Mr. Billy Lawler himself!
Now you come along. We're giving a little party at the Ritz in your honor.
For me? Oh, Miss Jones will be there in a minute! It's so exciting! They all love the show!
They all love you! That goes double for me. Now come on, we gotta go to the kids' party, all right?
Oh, gee, Billy, I don't know if I can. What about the party at the Ritz? Billy, am I really a star?
From now on and forever.
And can stars do anything they want?
Anything!
Then I want to go to the kids' party.
Come on, look. What, you haven't changed your mind?
I'm not. I'll be there in a minute. Wait for me at the stage door.
All right, but just 1 minute. Now you know how impatient tenors are.
Mr. Marsh.
Oh, Peggy. What's the matter with me? In all the excitement, I forgot to congratulate you. Congratulations, kid.
Thank you, Mr. Marsh. But you and I know who was really out there on that stage tonight. Oh, I said the lines and I sang the songs and I did the dances, but you were inside me. Honest dreams. So I congratulate you.
You're quite a girl, Miss Peggy Sawyer, quite a girl. And you're on your way to becoming quite a star. You've broken through, Peggy. You're that million to one shot that comes home a winner. Years from now, thousands of little chorus girls will be going to audition saying to themselves, who knows? I might come out of this another Peggy Sawyer. I only hope you'll be the type of star those little girls would want you to be. Shine your light over this glorious gulch they call 42nd Street. Give it your strength, your talent, your youth. Try if you can not to give it all your heart. Because it's a very loving heart and I would hate to see it broken. Now, go on to the Ritz and enjoy yourself.
I'm going to the kids' party.
What is right? You're quite a girl.
Good night, Mr. Marsh.
Good night. Allentown. Oh, I say, where is the kids' party?
It's at Lorraine's. The address is on the call board. And Mr. Marsh, it would be grand if you would come.
Street. Little nifties of the 50s, innocent and sweet. Sexy ladies of the 80s who are indiscreet. They're side by side, they're glorified. Where the underworld can meet the elite. Second Street.